Guys, they said Queen Naomi hugged Kabiesi so passionately, as in, they said Kabiesi was surprised the way Queen Naomi hugged and refused to let go, you know? And this is happening because she was so happy, as in super happy. She never expected what Kabiesi did. As a matter of fact, they said Kabiesi did not even discuss it with neither her nor Dr. Elizabeth, that he was just busy discussing it with his father and the brothers, and they really surprised Queen Naomi and Dr. Elizabeth big time. Anyway, guys, let me gist you. According to the news, they said when Queen Naomi returned back from US with the Oyotunji village, you know that Queen Naomi and Dr. Elizabeth went to Oyotunji village to go and represent Kabiesi. And after hearing a whole lot of stories and revelation, that confession and everything, the third thing was so much, Queen Naomi decided that she would not be the one, or Dr. Elizabeth, to tell Kabiesi all of this. That since there is someone who can do the telling, you know, the storytelling, to tell Kabiesi everything that happened, how they cried the man, the roles that his own Oloris have played and all of that, they said Queen Naomi started persuading the princess, the Oyotunji princess, to return back to Ilefe with them so as to meet with Kabiesi, you know. And they said Queen Naomi and Oniofife has been planning to go there for their annual conference, but this one happened now. So at the end of everything, despite all the dramas that actually went there to cause, they said Queen Naomi was able to convince the princess to return back with them. So when they returned, you know, Queen Naomi brought her to the palace after spending some time with her. They said they first went to Lekki Mansion. It was from Lekki Mansion that they came to the palace. Then when Queen Naomi wanted to leave, you know, leave the palace after bringing the Oyotunji princess to stay with Kabiesi, you know, they said Kabiesi told Queen Naomi that she was not going. Queen Naomi was like, ah, you want me to sleep in your room? They said Kabiesi told her that this is your home, that you are going to be staying here from now onwards. They said Queen Naomi was surprised. They said she was kind of playing with Kabiesi, telling Kabiesi, do you expect her to go back to that Yeyoluwa quarter? That is not happening, you know. Or you want her to go to those places where the Olori is packed out, that is below her status. That was when they said Kabiesi told her, no, you are not going anywhere. They said Kabiesi was just teasing her. And she was curious, asking Kabiesi, okay, where do you know it is my wish to come and stay here. But for the fact that things are not the way it should be, it's better that they wait until everything is settled. That is what they said Queen Naomi was telling Kabiesi, you know. So, but Kabiesi was like, don't you trust me? Don't you know why they call me Arole Odudua? I am the king. Hey, they said Queen Naomi was like, and they said they were just joking about it. Oh, Queen Naomi did not think that Kabiesi was serious, because the way he was saying it, it doesn't look serious on him and all of that. Queen Naomi was just following the joke, thinking that it's all a joke. Now maybe after the joke, she will return back to Akure, that because it was getting dark already from what we heard. Around afternoon, yes. So at some point, they said Kabiesi told her that, look, do you know that royalty looks so good on you? And for that reason, you are going to move into this royal manor. They said Queen Naomi was like, what are you saying? Do you know what you are saying? They said Queen Naomi was a bit confused when Kabiesi told her that preparations have been made for her to move into that place. Hey! They said Queen Naomi could not hold her joy. She was like, what do you mean? As in, did the elders know about it? Because Queen Naomi know that it is not Kabiesi's decision alone to make. Queen Naomi Kabiesi told her that he have taken care of all of that. That the only thing he needs to do right now is for him to the only thing she needs to do is for Queen Naomi to tell Kabiesi all the things that she needs in that place. Let her go there, check the things that she will be needing that is not there, and then come back to him to let him know the things that he'll be needing, that everything will be made available today, tomorrow. Hey. They said, Queen Naomi was like, are you joking? Are you for real? Hey. She told the second BSC told her that you and Tolu happens to be the Oyotunji princess will be staying there. But the moment Tolu returned back to US, you will be there, you know, until they are able to fix your place. The second Naomi was like joke. Oh. The thing is became serious. So then when she moved in there, they said she was just the thing was just doing her as if KBSC is serious, KBSC is not serious. That when she know that KBSC was very, very serious was when she mentioned those things that she needed and KBSC started ordering immediately. I even asked her to order from her own vendors if she have some. They said the moment they were doing the ordering, KBSC was busy doing the transfer. Hey! At that point, the Zekwenomi was like, this is real, oh. It is not joke, oh. That is how they said she hugged KBSC and thanked KBSC. They said when she hugged KBSC, she refused to let KBSC go. KBSC was telling her it's okay. They said she started shedding tears of joy because that is tears of joy. She was telling KBSC that KBSC, God, you are just God sent to me. That you are my blessing in this life. You are this. You are that. They said the way she was praising KBSC. You know, she know how to praise KBSC very well. I know. If you watch her videos, especially that day that KBSC celebrated the last birthday while she was in the palace, Kwenami knows how to praise KBSC better than any of those Oloris, including Ashley, who will always come out to let us know that KBSC is this, KBSC is that, and yet she couldn't even respect KBSC. You know? They said Kwenami started praising KBSC. Kwenami was just holding KBSC, calling, as in praising him, calling him all manner of good names, my Okomi, my this, my that, hey. They say at some point, KBSC have to remind you, okay, now I have heard you. Oh, yeah, now I leave me now. Hey, they say, I'm not leaving you. Oh, I'm not leaving you. This is too much. And the worst part of it is that KBSC took them unawares. They said Dr. Elizabeth herself was not aware of it. And they said, because Kwenami was telling Dr. Elizabeth, so you knew all of this. You didn't even tell me. And Dr. Elizabeth said, true, that she doesn't know anything about this. And KBSC told Kwenami there that Dr. Elizabeth did not know about it. That she know, that KBSC know that if he tell Dr. Elizabeth about it, that Dr. Elizabeth would want to tell Kwenami about it. So that is why they decided to hide it from all of them. Even the Oloris, none of them, not even one of them, was aware of what happened until. But that is the best thing to do. That is the best way to do things. As a king, you need to keep certain things secret until when they mature. Mm-hmm. Because if you keep opening your mouth, all these Oloris, they will just run you down because they know they are not there for something good. Anyway, guys, they said it was a very happy moment for KBSC and Kwenami, including Dr. Elizabeth. Anyway, guys, I want to remind you that these are all alleged information, okay? Thanks for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and share this video. Bye. Love you guys.